morning, students. So today we will start the fifth chapter of the class 6. The name is Separation of Substances. So in this chapter, we will be discuss about the separation. So before the separations, we will just try to understand the meaning of substances. We know that all those substances which are seen in our surroundings, objects, components, they will be known as the substances. And we classify the substance into the two groups. One is pure substance. Pure substance, and the second one is mixed substance. So pure substance, I think you get the meaning of the pure substance. Pure, those substance which are made by the single component. I will write here single component. Okay, so those substances which are made by the single components, they will be known as the pure substance. For example, like water, you can say that water is a pure component. It is made by the single substance, okay, and etc. Okay, now mixed substance, we can say it is a mixture. It is always the addition of the two or more substances. So mixed substance is the addition of two or more substance or component. For example, tea, coffee, etc. We know that tea is also consist by the few component like water, sugar, and tea leaves. Okay, so that are present in the tea. So we can say tea is example of the mixed substance. So in this chapter, we will discuss about the separation of substance. So we know that separations can be possible in the mixed substance. Why? Because it is consist of the two or more substance. It is not possible in the pure substance. Why? Because it is made by the single components, and what we will be separate out from the single component. Okay, so it is not possible. There is not possible. So we will just talking about the mixed substance. And we will take here some examples, the common examples which we see in the liquid, solid, and gaseous substances. So first is air. Air is a common substance of the mixture of gases. We know that air is mixture of gases. So it's a common example. We know that air is made by the hydrogens, helium, lithium, carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen. Okay, so it is a mixture of gases. Second is mixture of liquid. I take the example milk. Milk is a common example of the mixture of liquid. How? Because we know that milk is containing some amount of the oil substance. Oil substance like butter. We know butter we extract from the milk by some process, and oil has a butter has a oil nature substances, and it also contains some amount of the water. So it contains some oil substance plus water substance. Okay, if you are not understanding what I write the oil and waters, so I just classify them. The liquid we classify the liquid into the two groups on the basis of their natures. One is oil nature substance, second is water nature substance. And we know that those substances which belong to the water natures, they cannot be dissolved into the oil substance. And those substances which have oil natures, they cannot be dissolved into the waters, because they have property of those substances. Oil and water, both cannot be dissolved in each other. They have different properties. So similarly, we will just take a large number of substances which belong to the oil, like butter, petroleum, kerosene, diesel, those substances which will belong to the oil. And waters, they are also large components which belong to the water natures. Okay, so I think you get the meaning. Both are different properties. And oil is a mixture of both substances. So we can say that it is a mixture of liquid. It also contains some amount of substance, but we are not discussing here. We will just, I explain you the oil and water substance, and it is a mixture of oil and water substance. Now, third is soil. We know that it is a mixture of solid substance. Mixture of solid substance. We know that soil is consist of some amount of sand, clay, or there are some other substances which are formed in the solid. They are also present in the soils. So we can say that soil is a mixture of the solid substance. So I think you get the meaning that are the common example of the gas, liquid, and solids. So here we will discuss about. Okay, so I think you get the meaning of the separations, substances, and mixtures. Now we will just talk about the what are the benefit of the separating of substances. So next topic is benefit of separation. So after the separations, what we get? Suppose we have a tea, we met a tea, and we know that there are tea leaves that is undesirable substance, okay, and we don't want to pour it in our cups. So definitely we have to remove it from our tea. So how we'll remove it? By using a stamp, and we pour the tea in a cups by using a stamp, it will be separate out easily. So separations, we are talking about the benefit. What are the benefit? Firstly, we get pure component or substance after the separations. So after the separations, we get the pure form of the substance. In the example of tea, I get the pure form of tea because I didn't want the tea leaves in my cup of tea. Okay, second, I just remove the impurities from the impurities means the undesirable substance. Okay, because the tea leaves are not desirable substance in the tea. So I just remove it by using the string. So we can say that it also helps, it is beneficial to remove the undesirable substance. Removing undesirable substance. Okay. And sometimes these undesirable substances are the harmful, so we can also write that it will also beneficial for removing harmful substances. So I think you get the meaning of benefit of the separations. Firstly, we will get the pure form of the components. Second, we will easily remove the impurities or harmful substances. So these are the benefits of the separations.